One step. Two step. Ooh. Three step. Ooh. Four step. Ooh, can we get one more? Five step. Can we get another one? She was right behind me. Good day, good people. United States Aviators back. And today we are on Bucket of Jolts playing Look in the Window 1.0. It is a short, I believe it was described as horror visual novel, so we'll see how it goes. Never played anything horror on this channel, so prepare for the worst. She stood behind me in the mirror-like window on the second floor landing. I don't see her. Where is she? I really don't. I don't see her yet. I cocked my head to the side. Who was behind me? I didn't recognize her. She was elegant, elderly. Grandma? Is that you? I also, side note, I really like the soft music. It's really nice. Her hair was gray. Her long gray hair was up in a neat bun. Her skin was silvery, unnaturally pale. Well, see, now you're looking a little bit creepy, Grandma. She was tall and long, thin and light. You sound like the Slender Man. I'm sorry. Slender Woman. Because we know your gender. Based on the pronouns, unless me, the main character, am assuming your gender, Slender Woman, in which case, I apologize. Please don't attack me with your tentacles. She was wearing a long beige dress with an apron. She stood there, staring at a spot above my head, as if looking at her reflection. Who was she? And now we're back outside, okay. Looking back, people had told me she was here, that this was where she always was. No one saw all of her. Everyone saw something. A flash of a dress. A flick of a hand. Something out of the corner of your eye, always in the second story window. Still don't see her. She's always been there. No one knew who she was. I told you, it's my grandma, the Slender Woman. No one knows how she got there. She just was. And she always would be. I wouldn't care. Normally. Why do we care now? Hold on. Since this is technically a scary, spooky horror game, I'm gonna stop you right there, main character me. I would care. I would not care. I would actually never care. Not normally, not abnormally. Both instances, I'd be like, I'm out. Everyone sees her. I don't see her. I'm blind. You can't see. She's John Cena to me. I can't see her. I don't believe in ghosts. Oh, she's a ghost. Now I really can't see. I'm out of... Packing up. Packing my bags. We are out of here. Where's my burlap sack? You know what, we'll just keep going. Usually. I usually don't believe in ghosts. I don't believe in ghosts. There must be someone behind me. No one. No one was at the top of the stairs. I turned back, confused. She moved one step closer. How do you know? You said no one was there. If she moved one step closer, you need to move eight steps further. Get out of there, homie. Her eyes are now on me. Her face, emotionless, cold. I knew she should leave. I knew I should leave. She should leave, too. In fact, if I leave, she should stay here and never get together with me again. It was a bad Tinder date, I tell you. This isn't a game I should play. Well, I guess I'll close out. This has been Bucket of Jolts, the United States Aviator, taking off, telling you to stay classy, passengers, and I will see you all next time. Toodaloo, flight crew. Okay, now, yeah, let's finish this game. I'm sorry. But I'm curious. She doesn't seem menacing. I'm not afraid. She feels calm and empty. I turn back to the stairs. No one. Back to the window. One step closer. We continue our game back and forth, closer and closer, her expression never changing, my curiosity growing and growing. What will she do when she gets to me? Look, when ghosts usually get to you, they either possess you, snap your neck, possess you and snap your neck, or have a nice luncheon? I'm sure Casper would have a nice luncheon with somebody. Will she touch me? No, you don't want that. Will I touch her? That better be consensual. Will she disappear? Will I? Ooh, that's a good question. I don't know. And I shouldn't want to know. You sure shouldn't. But I do. Why do you want to know? We are not the same character. Character and I, we have some major differences here. He wants to go and find out what's going on, but I know it's a ghost, and I say it's true. It's damn true. And then I'm not gonna go. So we continue. I said don't go. Ooh. One step. Two step. Ooh. Three step. Ooh. Four step. Ooh, can we get one more? Five step. Can we get another one? She was right behind me. I could feel her cold breath on my neck. No, that is not okay. No. I could feel her chill radiate on my body. Okay. She whispered. What did she whisper? This is my one more time to go, 'cause I'm out of here. This has been your United States Aviator taking off, telling you to stay classy, passengers, and I will see you. Okay, fine, let's do it. Part of me wanted to walk away. All of me wants to walk away. Work away. Walk away. Part of me knew I shouldn't turn around, knowing something would happen, but what did you do? Part of me knew she wouldn't let me. What should I do? Oh boy. Can I save it? Excellent. Face her. I turn. Her body is cold. We stand nose to nose, her freezing body freezing me. Every breath is a struggle. I see the wrinkles around a tight-lipped mouth. Pale freckles on a pale face, still emotionless, still regal. Her eyes, the only part of her not beige. They are a piercing, freezing blue. She is menacing now, but I'm not afraid to fight some ghosts. Everybody, gonna ecto punch a whole bunch of ghosts. All right, let's keep going. I imagine a house with a great door. She stands before it, and she slowly raises a hand to knock on my door. And I let her in.
Look in the window.
Is that it? Okay. Okay. I knew it was short. I did. I really did know it was short, but I liked it. I liked the closure of don't look in the window, you guys. But we got one more thing to do. We were left at this decision, and now we gotta leave. Bye. Oh wow, we dipped. This is my decision. I run, and I don't look back, and I don't return to the house. But every so often, I feel her eyes on the back of my neck. I broke the rules, so now she can too. She begs me constantly to return. She begs me to go back to the stairs. Begs me.
Look in the window.
I'm glad okay, yeah, that one is much more terrifying, to be honest. That one is a much more terrifying ending. almost, I was 100% sure that was going to happen as soon as the character said, and she breaks the rules too. And I was like, no, You still play by the rules. You stay in your house. But apparently she wanted to leave with me. Ladies and gentlemen, this was short. It was nice, though. It was a nice experience. Continue making games, game creator. The link to this game is down in the description below. But until next time, this is your United States Aviator taking off for real this time, telling you all to stay classy, passengers, and I will see you all next time. Toodaloo. Flight.